In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use Excel's Goal Seek feature. So what is Goal Seek and why would you want to use it? Well, Goal Seek is great for cases when you know the end result, but you don't know how to get there. For example, imagine that you work in the sales department and your boss comes to you and says, "Show me the numbers. Show me how much revenue we made this month." So you pull out your spreadsheets and in there, you're doing a bunch of calculations. You have prices, you have the units sold, and you have the revenue, right? So that revenue number that you provide to your boss is the result of a formula. You tell your boss, well, the revenue is like 2,000 bucks. And your boss asks you, how many units do we need to sell to get to 2,500? Now, you have an option of changing that unit so you can plug in different numbers till you get 2,500, or you can use Goal Seek. Now, let's take a look at a very simplified sales report. We have units sold of a specific product. We have the price per unit. So these two are input fields. And we have the revenue calculated by just multiplying units sold with the price. Now we're asked, how many units do we need to sell to get a revenue of 2,500? You have different options. You could come to units sold here. You can change this number. Let's go to 600. Okay, we're still far, 700. Okay, we're getting closer, 650. You can play around with this number until you get to the desired outcome. You can also do a calculation somewhere else. You could say, we want to get to 2,500, so the units sold would be this divided by our price. That would be around 658 units that we need to sell to get to a revenue of 2,500. You can also obviously do this calculation in your head if you're good with doing math in your head. Personally, I really like to work with numbers, but I'm really bad at doing math in my head. Goal Seek is actually my go-to tool for solving these type of questions. Where do you find Goal Seek? It's in the Data tab under What If Analysis, and you'll see it right here. So I'm going to show you how simple it is. All you need to define is the cell that you want to change. So this has to be the cell that has the formula in it. For us, that's B5. Okay, so that's right. What value do we want to set it to? To 2,500. Which cell do we want to change? We want to change this one. And we say, okay. We get 658 as our solution. The good thing about Goal Seek is that it doesn't change your formulas. It doesn't change anything here. All it does, if you accept the results of Goal Seek, it puts that number in your input field, but doesn't touch anything on your calculation field. This is a very simple example of Goal Seek, but the good thing about it is that it's not just for direct formula references. So let's say our report is bigger. So let's take a look at the cost side of things. We have the expenses per unit sold. Let's say cost per unit is around, let's say 1.5, and our full costs are going to be the number of units that we sell multiplied by the cost per unit. This is going to be an input field. This is a calculated field. So I'm just going to apply this formatting right here. Now what we want is to calculate our income. Our income is just revenue minus our expenses. Okay, so that's that, and that we can use the same formatting for. Now let's say that we're asked, how many units do we need to sell to get to an income of 2,100? We can use Goal Seek for that as well. So we go back to Data, What If Analysis, Goal Seek. The cell that we want to change is this one. That's fine. We're going to change it to 2,100. Which cell do we want to change? The units sold. To get to an income of 2,100, we need to sell 913 units. If we don't accept this, we go back to what we had in the cells before. What if you wanted to change multiple things? Like you saw here in Goal Seek, you can just change one thing, one cell. So I can't say I'd like to change units sold, but I also like to change the price. But the price shouldn't go above 4 because there's no way anyone would buy at that price. So if I want to set constraints and have multiple cells changing to get to the end result, I need to use Solver. And that's what I'm going to cover with you in the next video. If you like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And for more videos like this one, why not subscribe to my channel so that you can get updates when new videos come out.